Right, okay, so let's have a look at this question. It goes, a particle of 5 kg initially at rest at that position is acted on gravity, that's minus 9.8, and also these forces 1 and 2. So if we've got those two forces, let's have a look at this. So you've got 15. So we've got forces in action, so we're going to use Newton's second law, force equals mass times acceleration, since it's asking me for the acceleration vector. So the resultant force, we got 15 minus 8 plus, this is another vector that's acting on it, plus gravity minus 9.8, and that's going to be now what's acting on it is its weight, so that is weight is W equals mg. M is the weight, which is the mass, which is 5, and g is the vector, gravitational vector is 0, and then it's falling down by 9.8. the pull is minus 9.8, and that's going to equal to mass, which is 5, times the acceleration vector. So once you got all this into play, solve all this, that plus that 8 0, so that will be 8, that plus that minus 10, 5 times that is minus 49, minus 49, minus 10, minus 59. Is that what you got?
Yeah.
And that is equal to 5a. So if I divide that by 5, so the vector A is going to be 5 divided by that. Now 5 divided by 8 is 1.6. And 5 divided by 55 is 11, so that's minus 11. 4 over 5 is 8. So that is the acceleration vector. So the first one, 3 marks, happy days. Now, find the position. Find the position vector of the particle after 10 seconds. Now, that's the force. The forces do not change. If the forces do not change, the acceleration doesn't change. So this is a Savart question, okay? If the forces, unless there's an extra force active, it doesn't say anything. So if the force, the constant force is the same, the acceleration is constant. So this is Savart, okay? Now, we want to know what we have in order to use Savart. We got the acceleration. What we got time t equals 10 seconds. So we got that, and we know that equals 10 seconds. I'm just trying to see what else have we got. We need the final position. We want s, okay, and we've got the initial, that's okay. So just 1 minute, initially at rest. So we know that we also got u is equal to 0. Now, if we got all these elements, we can then say Savart, so that was rest. So we know that the displacement is gonna, the displacement vector is gonna equal to ut plus half a t squared. So what we got is, we got u is 0, so 0 times 10 is 0, that's gone. Acceleration, so we got to half that, so I'll put this, I'm going to sub this in, half times, now t is 10, 10 squared is 100, times the vector, so that's the scalar outside, 1.6, and that's minus 11.8. Now, you can use a calculator, there's no problem. That half of that is 50. All right, somebody shout it out. 50 times 1.6 is, come on, you should know this.
80.
And if you do 50 times minus 11.8 is, so Sorry?
590.
Good. So that is the displacement. We want to know, we want to know the position vector. So if we want the position,
that's minus.
If we want the position vector, we get the initial vector where it's initially at, so it's going to be 245. And if we add on this displacement, which is 80 minus 590, you will end up 80 plus 2 is 82, and minus 45 plus 45 is minus 545. So that will be the position vector of where it ends up.